Hello, Tara. My apologies for exposing you and your son to this kind of treatment, but I can assure you it is not without reason. The man before you just made the sacrifices to save the life of a loved one. However, when given the opportunity to save your husband's life, he chose not to. Now you will be given the power to save a life. Will you grant this man the opportunity to continue living, or will you dispense the same death sentence he issued your husband? Live or die. The choice is yours.
It's not my game.
I'm leaving you a box today, and its contents are of grave importance.
Miss Tuck, what's in the box?
John left you 5 envelopes. The 6th one was for me. This is John's will.
He had no choice! He always had a choice!
The reason I am doing this isn't because I can't forgive you for what you did to me. The reason I'm doing this is because I couldn't forgive myself for what you might do to someone else.
Please, no. Please.
You will never heal again.
Please.
Death sentence.
So in a sense, you choose who lives or dies.
It's policy, John. It's policy.
Who devised that format? You think it's the living who will have ultimate judgment over you, because the dead will have no claim over your soul. But you may be mistaken.
Game over.
No! No, you won't
convince
Detective. I don't need one.
Oh, yeah?
You know why you're here, don't you?
You feel you now have control, don't you? You think you will walk away untested.
I'm only carrying out John's final request.
Do you like how brutality feels, Mark?
From now on, I control all aspects of the game.
That's not what John wanted.
You want a chance? I'll give you a chance.